Okay, this might look a little weird, but I'm adding tiny plasma beam T-Rex heads on the T-Rex head. Yep. That's what we got. Using every body part and everything in the game. This so far is how it's coming along. Welcome back to Animal Revolt Battle Simulator. Today's first suggestion says, give Barry a step uncle who is the headless Hulk unit. Also, name him Bill. So this right here is Bill. How you doing, buddy? Great, glad to hear you're okay. So Bill here has actually been scaled up because Barry's team, there's a lot of large units, and I think if he was small, it wouldn't make a lot of sense. Now, I know this might seem a little weird, but I kind of want to give him a giant eyeball in replacement for his head, because obviously his head is down in his hand here. And then another thing I'm going to do is give the eyeball some horns. Yeah, there we go. Now, I also reckon Bill here could probably do with some extra armor as well. So far, Bill is coming along nicely. We've added some extra spikes to his cleaver here, but I've also had a really cool and messed up idea. What if we add some tentacles coming from his stomach here? So it's like an alien is being ripped out of him. I mean, how disturbing is that? All right, I think that is Bill ready to go. Welcome to Barry's team, Bill. And now we're about to see Bill in action for the very first time. He is going up against Goru over there. But before we do that, 77.5% of you are not actually subscribed. So make sure you click that subscribe button to see more of my content. All right, here we go. Throwing him in the deep end against Goru, a very, very powerful unit. All right, throw the head. Here we go. Yes. Oh no, Goru's having a tough time here. He's got him in the knee. It goes to Cleaver. Oh, the tentacles are going crazy right now. Oh no, he's been slammed. And just like that, he is dead. Bill has been defeated. And you know what? I'm kind of glad he has, because he is messed up. So now it's time for the big fight. We have Gary's team right here, minus the bodyguard like last time. And then of course we have all of Barry's team, including the brand new and terrifying Bill. So yeah, last time Gary's team won, but now that they have Bill on their side, who knows? Start the battle. Here we go. Oh man, that looks so cool. In goes the parrot. Oh, he's picked up Bill. Bill, no. Why did he go for Bill straight away? I think Bill is already dead. You know what? I really thought Bill would do better than that. Mr. Nibbles, I think his name is. He's now dead as well. You know, I'm kind of thinking Gary's team are going to win this one. Also, doesn't Gary's team have a Hydra now? Where's the Hydra at? But yeah, it looks like Gary's team is winning by a long shot here. Man, we definitely need to improve Barry's team quite a bit, so make sure you keep leaving your suggestions in the comment section down below. Give Barry some love. But yeah, keep leaving normal suggestions too. It doesn't have to be Barry related. Oh no, look, the minion's getting messed up. And just like that, I think. Oh wait, no, the worm is still in the sky. No one can get to it. But yeah, all that's left is Gary's team and the worm. Take that worm out. Look how disturbing it is. They're all trying to climb up and get it, but they can't. Right, you know what? Gary's team have won. They just can't get the worm. I've just realized there was loads of members missing from Gary's team and they still won. That just shows how powerful they really are. Look, even Gary's big brother, he wasn't even needed. Now, it's been a little while since I've been on this map, but I thought it would make the next suggestion a little bit more interesting. And it says, day one of asking Fudgy to make an army of Spartan warriors versus skeleton army, so it can be a war. So yeah, these guys are just scaled up and just for show. So let's go ahead and remove them. Now, something to note here is the Skeleton Warriors are $22 and the Spartan Warriors are $14. So I guess that means the Skeletons are more powerful? I'm not too sure. But either way, let's spawn in the armies. Some units will definitely fall off. Right, now let's get some Skeleton Warriors in. So if they fall, that is a long way down. Right, let's start this battle. Here we go, Spartan Warriors versus Skeleton Warriors. The Skeletons are actually struggling to get up the hill. Oh, here we go. Come on, Spartans. You got this. I am on team one with the Spartan Warriors here. I want them to win. Oh man, what a mess. I have no idea who's winning right now, I'll be honest. So far, no one has fallen off. Oh, that skeleton almost did, though. Oh, no, the skeletons are winning. No, no. Oh, he's fallen. Only one has fallen. How has that even happened? Well, down he goes, and we have lost. The skeletons have won the fight. It's okay, soldier. Stop freaking out. But don't worry. I have just the thing to make sure that the Spartan warriors win. We have two lava golems in the back here, as you can see. But the only issue is the other team has the Scourge unit. So now let's see what happens, shall we? I just realized it was probably a really bad idea actually putting them at the back. Whoa, he's accidentally thrown his own skeletons. Oh, hang on a minute. Lava golems, don't roll off the map, please. Yes, there we go. One of them's gone. Great. Absolutely useless, you, mate. That one's dead as well. Oh, no, the Scourge is still alive. No, I think we're going to lose again. Those lava golems was a terrible idea because they'll just end up rolling off the map. And just like that, I think we might have lost. Yes, we have lost. That's it. I am tired of losing. So what I've done, I've spawned in an army of wyverns, as you can see. So these guys will not fall to their death because, of course, they can fly. Right, start the battle. I mean, we have to win this time around. There's no way we're losing. I mean, look at that. We've just wiped them all off. Barely any skeletons have survived. Oh, yes. I feel like I'm cheating a little bit with all these wyverns, but you know what? Ah, screw it. Oh, wait, Spartan Warriors, what are you doing? No! Don't fall off like that. No, what are you doing, you idiots? The Scourge unit, I think, is the last alive now. Look how powerful he is. Oh, no. Oh, they're going to get messed up. Oh, geez. I am so sorry about that, dude. Wyverns, come on, attack. Throw him off or something. What the? Where did you come from? That's it. Oh, no. That wyvern got slammed into the wall. He got messed up. Oh, they're all getting destroyed. Look at him go. Why is the Scourge unit this powerful? Come on, wyverns. Why are you all stuck to the wall like that? You're just going to get picked off by him. Let me check on his health. Well, he is pretty low, but he's just killing them one by one. Oh! Oh! What the? I actually don't think I've seen a wyvern and the Scourge unit fight one-on-one. So this is what it would be like. They just get tossed around like they're nothing. Fellas, now's the time to fly away. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Is he nearly dead? Yes, he's almost dead. Come on, just a few more attacks on the Scourge unit and he's down. Come on, guys. Oh, no! The way he just froze them like that. All right. So, wait, we got more wyverns over here, right? I can hear them. Where are they? Is it just that one? Well, he's dead now. Oh, they're stuck on the other side of the wall. Great. Well, you know what? I'm going to see this as a victory because the Scourge unit is extremely low and there's three or four of them left. So, yeah, they would definitely be able to kill him. Moving on. Day 100. No, really. Wow, that's actually pretty impressive. I'm asking Fudgy to download creations by Finn the Shark King, aka me, and make them fight your creations. So starting off, we have Bowl. Yep, this is one of his creations. It's a Purosaurus body with a T-Rex head and tail. So Bowl, meet Carl. This is my creation right here. This guy is, of course, in the workshop for you guys to check out. An absolute unit. I love this guy. And Carl, all I'm saying is if you don't take down Baal over there, I'm going to be severely disappointed in you. Right, here we go. I'm not even sure if Baal has updated stats or anything like that. Come on, Carl. Take Carl. Carl, no! No, Carl! Hang on a minute. Look at the stats. Some attached weapons have attack multiplier not set to one. So I'm guessing his head here is probably set to like 1,000 or something crazy. All right, so it's not just Baal that I downloaded. I also got Deathjaw, which is another one of his units. And look at the size of this guy. This guy looks really impressive. And by the way, this person has created a lot of workshop creations in Arbs. And yeah, I've only selected two of them. But I am very, very concerned with this one right here. Let me check the stats real quick as well. Yeah, I think it's fair to say we are screwed. The thing that worries me the most is where it says some attached weapons have attack multiplier not set to one. So we have absolutely no idea what they could be. Anyway, Cole, good luck, buddy. Go, go, go. Get him. Oh, we've been grappled. Come on, dude. Oh, man. He's ginormous. We don't stand a chance. Oh, no. I feel so sorry for Carl right now. Come on, Carl. You can do this. If he won, I'll be so proud. Oh, man. Look at those spikes. Look at those things. Look like giant claws as well. All right, let's check on the health. Oh, Carl has actually done some damage. But unfortunately for him, he is going to die. Oh, he's been knocked off the map. Oh, and he is gone. All right. We need a stronger unit to take this guy down. So I'm going to send in my upgraded Hydra. I think, does this one come with plasma beams? It doesn't. Okay, you know what? Doesn't matter. We don't need them anyway. Start the battle. Actually, you know what? We actually might need those. Wait, what? What kind of stats did I give this guy? Oh, well, that makes sense. That's why we won so easily. Yeah, take that, Deathjaw. Now, instead of sending in an overpowered Hydra, I thought I would just spawn in a bunch of my random creations that I've made over the time. And you know what? I'm just gonna remove this one. Let's pretend you never saw that. Okay, here we go. We got this boar here. For some reason, he's going in circles. A classic Fudgy creation. Oh, man. Whoa, spider! What's happening to you? Oh no! Now he's messing everyone up! Come on, Skeleton Rex thing. You got this. Yeah, I think we might be losing this battle pretty badly. Look at the Titanoboa as well. Why did I even create that thing? Pretty weird. Oh yes! Lava Golem, bro! Attack! Oh no, I thought he was gonna get pushed out of the map there, but he's okay. Yeah, Skeleton T-Rex here is doing pretty good. Or maybe not, because he's been thrown out of the map, which means it's all up to the Lava Golem now. Come on, dude! Come on, buddy, you got this! Oh no! Ah, we lost again. Great creation, though. I actually really like this thing. Really cool. This next suggestion says, day one of asking Fudgy to use every body part and everything and name him God of Arbs. So I guess the suggestion is saying we use every weapon, every limb, and just everything that we can attach to a unit, right? I mean, I'm going to do that anyway because that sounds pretty cool. So I thought I would use the T-Rex here. I'm a big fan of the way the T-Rex looks. I've also upgraded some of his stats. And he is, of course, scaled up. Not to mention, I still want to take down Deathclaw. I'm not done with him yet, so I want to make sure this guy is powerful enough to take him down. Now, the question is for this challenge, am I allowed to use more than one of everything? I mean, we can't use animal bases. We can't use any robotic bases, but we can add heads, which means... Wait, does that mean I have to use every single one of these as well? Okay, this might look a little weird, but I'm adding tiny plasma beam T-Rex heads on the T-Rex head. Yep, that's what we got. Using every body part and everything in the game. This so far is how it's coming along. Yeah, we have a bunch of dinosaur heads, carnivorous dinosaur heads, on the T-Rex arms. We still haven't added the Hellhound yet. So let's add this on like this. Actually, no, wait, no. The Hellhound should actually, you know, shoot out fire. It pretty makes sense to have him like here. And then the demon can be on his chin. Yep, perfect. I've had an idea. What if we add a Purosaurus head on each of his toes? Although for some reason, it doesn't seem to want to work on this side. I guess that's the best we're going to get. Right, you know what? I am pretty much done. I didn't add some decorations like the feathers and stuff because there's just so many variations. And I don't think it would really add much to this unit right here. So this is God of Arbs. And it looks ridiculous. I mean, you know what? It could be very powerful though. So I say we try it out. So first up, we have Goru. Oh my goodness. This thing can barely walk. What is happening? And it's dead just like that. But now it is time for the main battle. We have here my creation, God of Arbs versus Deathjaw. And as you can see, they're about the same size with similar upgrades in terms of the stats, except I have a bunch of plasma beams and also T-Rex heads that shoot out plasma beams too. All right, prepare for war. Start the battle. Oh yes, look at that thing go. That is insane. Deathjaw, you are going down. Oh, we have done it. Take that. Didn't stand a chance. Look at all these items we have on us. The tentacles there, the spikes, Purosaurus head as toes. It's insane. So next up to fight God of Arbs is Godzilla. I think I know who's going to win this fight, but let's do it anyway. Here we go. Oh, we're dead straight away. Godzilla has defeated us right away there. We didn't stand a chance. But anyway, on that note, I'm going to end this one right here. There's another video on the top right, so make sure you go ahead and check that out. Also, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll hopefully see you in that video right there. Goodbye.